soccer. And add to that the world's most famous team, and you have an unbeatable combination. Cosmos Soccer. This afternoon, the talented Cosmos start another journey, hopefully to another championship. This is Cosmos Soccer. From Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California, the Cosmos meet the San Jose Earthquakes. Brought to you in part by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by Getty, who wants to get the most out of your car. And by General Tire, where you find quality, choice, and price. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jim Karvellas, together with Seamus Malin, my old friend. And yes, we're ready for another exciting season of Cosmos Soccer. Seamus, we're starting a decade, a new decade. The Cosmos, the most famous team in the world. They won four NASL championships. My question to you, and maybe the question of the fans, is what can they do for an encore?
Well, they're also famous, Jim, for bringing in wonderful players from all over the world. It now seems that that era may be coming to a conclusion. The feature this year, I think, is going to be a new team concept. Weisweiler, in his first full year here, is going to emphasize the experience of the veterans, but lots of running from the young players.
So the point is, the Cosmos have many stars. They have kept those stars, and now they're going to try to work them into a tremendous team, which they have already. But Seamus, here in San Jose, California, where the Cosmos will be taking on the Earthquakes, San Jose had a tough, gritty club this year. They're going to be a competitive club this afternoon.
I think they will. You know, they have not had great success here, Jim, but this has been a remarkably enduring franchise. The fans here are unlike any around the league, and you have to win these games. You have to pay your dues on the road if you want to get to Soccer Bowl.
All right, we're getting ready for the start of this evening's game. We'll be back with the starting lineups. A reminder, you're watching Cosmos Soccer. Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. They came in the North American Soccer League in 1974, Seamus, when the league had its big expansion. And they've been a very successful team in the stands all that time. The first year, they were a very good team, period. But since then, I think their only problem has been that they have not won enough on the field, but the fans are still in the stands.
Well, fans are remarkably loyal. It's really quite an astonishing feat to see them come out here season after season, despite it, but really hoping for a turnaround this season.
You're having a good look at the 1981 Cosmos starting lineup. And from Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California, moments away from our national anthem. Out of the starting lineup, Seamus, for this afternoon's lid lifter. You say this afternoon, well, it's afternoon here in San Jose. It's evening back in New York. Take a look at San Jose.
Okay, Mike Hewitt will be starting in goal. He's a veteran goalkeeper from Scotland. Defenders Gary Ethering, the familiar name to Cosmos fans. Jimmy McAllister on the left side. Ratansky will be the sweeper, and Tony Powell will be out there trying to stop Giorgio Chinaglia. Here is Mike Hewitt. Mike Hewitt's been with this club for some time. In fact, he's the last surviving member of this team since the last time the Cosmos played here in 76. Had a rough season two seasons ago, but is real experienced and a gutsy keeper. He'll be tough to beat. In the midfield, they're going to have Alan Merrick, a veteran of the NASL from Minnesota and L.A. Joe Harbath, likewise a veteran here from the Diplomats, and Lisinar, Slavko Lisinar. And up front, Steve David, Tony Crescitelli, likewise from the Diplomats, and the immortal Georgie Best. Georgie Best, what the enfant terrible of the soccer world, a remarkably skillful man coming out of Belfast in Northern Ireland, a terrific career with Manchester United, lots of problems in his life, but he seems now to be turning it around. But that's been said before. Now the Cosmos are going to have a few changes, you'll see here. Hewitt Birkenmeyer, of course, in goal. Rice Bergen will be stopper. Rick Davis at one fullback. Boris Bandoff on the left side. And Bobby Yerushi is going to be the sweeper, the new player. Not a new player, but coming back once again to the Cosmos. But Rice Bergen is going to be very important. And there you see Wim. He was the MVP in the LA Classic last week. And I thought he was super in the Soccer Bowl, too. He had a great game there when last on television. Francois van der Elst and DiBernardo with Vladi Bogovic, and of course Romero will make the midfield four. Cosmos going with 4-4-2, and there's the two, Giorgio Chinaglia and Roberto Cabanas up front.
Hi, we're going to start the season. It's exciting. I, Crescitelli, will be kicking it off. Giorgi Best, I'm going to tell you more about Giorgi and what he's been doing of late. All right, deep on the right side now, attacking at San Jose. Play it out to Giorgi Best, and a drive over the top. George Best has been one of the world's great players. You know that he's had a problem, an alcohol problem. That's public. That came out in a Wire story. And he went into a home for alcoholics here in California. And I'm told, I talked to John Carberry, their vice president and general manager, he's coming along tremendously. He's really turned things around. I think the whole soccer world is pulling for Georgie Best. It was a shame to waste all that talent. And they expect him to play about 30 minutes. Right here is Rice Bergen. A 30 minutes, good 30 minutes from Georgie Best can destroy a team, so the Cosmos will be watching him very closely. This is Bogey. Now to Rice Bergen. That's Boris Bandoff playing at fullback. Jeff Durgan not playing today. He's under the weather. We may be hearing from Jeff during the telecast. Here's Ricky Davis starting at right fullback. Davis now to Giorgio, or check it to DiBernardo. Gonna have to get that straight. That hairline is incredible. Of course, Giorgio will be very mad that I said that. Cabanas, and a foul called on Steve David. Steve David, by the way, the second active leading scorer in the league behind Giorgio. He has 97 goals in his career. By Cabanas, and a foul called against Cabanas. Jimmy McAllister in the foul.
One of the things we ought to point out right away in this game is that the North American Soccer League yesterday announced that it will temporarily suspend the NASL rules for offsides and substitute in favor of the FIFA rules, and we'll explain that to you in regards to the 35-yard line in particular. It means no more 35-yard line for offside, although the line is physically on the field for shootout purposes.
My Cosmos come attacking now. Now you're running toward the corner, and now it's back to Hewitt. You know, the Cosmos have never won here. They played two times, once in 74. They lost in a tiebreaker. Last time we were here, August 7th, 1976, the Cosmos lost that one 2-1. Their only goal that game was by Keith Eddy in the 84th minute on a penalty kick. All right, Crescitelli with a chance. Birkenmeyer is out, and a great save. Great save by Hubert. So Hubert picking up right where he left off in soccer ball.
All right, a rather bad mistake there by Ricky Davis, who allowed Crescitelli to get behind him and did not make the interception. And you're quite right, Birkenmeyer, as has so often been the case in the past, making the very key save.
And I also noticed that San Jose really pressing forward. That was Rutanski on the attack, their sweeper, and they've already attacked with McAllister on the left side. You know that Etherington will be overlapping from the right fullback slot. So they're not going to play defensively here today. They're coming out to attack Cosmos. Good shot of Boris Bandoff down the midfield line. Long lead, good pass, van der Elst. Francois, cross, Chinaglia goal!
This is where we came in. Unbelievable already. The season's hardly open. What is it, about 3 minutes gone in the game? And it's already Chinaglia 1, San Jose nothing.
What a great cross by Francois van der Elst. A good ball to get him in position on the right side by Bandoff. Great ball. That was a Bandoff pass, and watch the cross.
Look at him, how he just gets his ball before it goes over the line. He bends it beautifully back around the defender, and then Giorgio is right there to slam it in, step right in front of Hewitt and put it away. But the important thing, I think, also, you just talked about Ratansky coming up as a sweeper, Jim, because he sees that there are only two attackers in the form of Quinalia and Cabanas, but the deadly overlapping from midfield is what you've got to watch out for when you're playing against a 4-4-2, and that's exactly what Van der Elst did. He saw the space left there, came up, got a lovely ball from Bandoff, and set up Giorgio for a classic Quinalia goal.
All right, 3 minutes into the game, the Cosmos on top, 1-0. Now Reisbergen, now to DiBernardo. Boris Bandoff, who played with this original San Jose team, by the way.
Went to Silver Creek High School here in San Jose.
All right, Reisbergen broke it up. Here's Joe Horvath, the veteran. He's been with a couple of clubs last year with Washington. DiBernardo, foul Joe Horvath.
Well, a sliding tackle by Angelo didn't look that serious, but let's take another look at it. He comes across with his right foot, I think he should do it in a sliding tackle. You'll see him come across with the right foot just now, and he flips the ball away, but he obviously did get Horvath on the ankle, and Horvath is clutching his ankle on the ground.
This program is authorized in the rights granted by the Cosmos solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing this program without the express written consent of the Cosmos, is prohibited. Well, Joe Horvath is up, and he will continue. Cosmos on top, 1-0. Georgie Best with a free kick. Lichinar into the side netting, and it'll be a goal kick for the Cosmos.
Horvath coming over here from the old Diplomats, always known for his lethal left foot, and you saw him in that run making a run towards the left side where he feels much more comfortable. Although we might add, in the pregame, his left foot didn't look too lethal, Jim, when he couldn't kick the ball as far as giving distributing free balls to him.
All right, nice ball by David on the right side. Etherington, and they're going to call offside. Offside against San Jose. Well, there's Gary Etherington. Started as a teenager with the Cosmos. Went to Los Angeles and now here in San Jose. Playing at right fullback. Does that surprise you, Seamus?
Yes, I'm really surprised indeed. I don't know if that will last long. When they take Georgie Best out, we might see him coming up to play in more in the midfield or all the way up to right wing.
I bend off. Now the ball to Quinalia. Giorgio ranging around midfield. Long high ball, no one there. All right, from San Jose, the Cosmos lead the San Jose Earthquakes 1-0. You're watching Cosmos Soccer.
This bud's for everyone. It stacks it and sacks it.
This bud's for you. King of Beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This Bud's for you.
People are saving gasoline by carpooling, but not the gas guzzler. While others do all their shopping in one trip, he doesn't.
Sir? Tires are low. I'll put some air in. You get better gas mileage.
Next time.
Excessive air conditioning wastes gasoline, too. If we saved a gallon of gasoline a week per car, we'd reduce oil imports over 10%. That's why Getty Oil wishes the gas guzzler would reform. We'd all get more miles for our money.
Right from San Jose, Jim Karvellas. 38 minutes to play in the first half. The Cosmos lead 1-0 on the Quinalia goal. 3 minutes into the game on a series of passes, really, from Bandoff to Van der Elst to Giorgio. Now Quinalia knocked down off the ball. There's Steve David. Davis, Ricky Davis. Deflected by Best. Bandoff couldn't control. Resicelli. Cosmos were asking for offside. It didn't matter. Rolled free to Birkenmeyer.
I think that Weisfeller would like a little bit more direct play from that back four, especially the less experienced ones at this level, that is Bandoff and Ricky Davis, and perhaps Iarushi, not so much less experienced, but less experienced in playing with these players. I think they want to move the ball forward, as you said, Jim, and therefore don't want too much play around the back.
All right, Bogey, Troy Giorgio, There'll be a Cosmos. Field is 66 yards wide. It used to be worse, Jamie. It used to be 62. 66, not bad. DiBernardo cross. Oh, that was dangerous. And Horvath comes off of the ball. Joe Horvath. Broken up by Romero. Hatsia Arushi to Ricky Davis.
Nice release pass there by Arushi, seeing the goalkeeper covered well and looking what looked like a dangerous pass, but not really. It was a very good, soft 10 to 15 yard pass at the top of the box.
Hi, Romero with Etherington. DiBernardo on the left. Cleared by Witanski. Horvath. Etherington, he coming to mark, Geary, Lichinar, David, good return to Lichinar. Irishi bothering just enough, right. So Lichinar couldn't pull the trigger.
Irishi read it well, he saw it was going to be a wall pass, and he cut for the receiver instead of waiting for the ball to leave. He made a move before the ball was passed and was in good position there to cut it away.
Well, nice to have Mark Brickley with us again. Fine director of media relations for the Cosmos, and always a great help to us. Also want to say hello to Carl Scheibach, who's not covering the game for the first time in over 5 years. The Stotts Herald. But Carl will be seeing you shortly in Jacksonville, to be exact. That'll be our next telecast next Saturday. Right, bogey with the ball. Bryce Bergen. Vim has been great during this tour. Lead for Kenaya, handled well by Powell. Now David. Jimmy McAllister. Broken up by Vander Els. Had a very good pass by Lichinar. Now Rick Davis. DiBernardo breaking on the left wing. Davis goes to the middle to Romero. Good ball on the right, Cabanas. High cross, not a good cross. Kick for Hewitt.
Not a very good cross, no, but nicely engineered by Romero, who used the decoy of Canalia and Bogachevich, who had drawn a couple of defenders going into the penalty area. He saw the open man was Cabana, so he pushed it wide, and of course that's just what you want to do. It's important to play the ball wide if the wide player's got some space in front of him to run into and doesn't just simply have defenders to run into.
Bryce Bergen won it. Vander Els. Kinaya. Romero behind Kinaya. Giorgio broke for the goal. And the pass behind him. Now San Jose to the midfield line. They've got some veterans on this team. Alan Merrick and Vest. Piarucci heads it over the sideline. Throw in San Jose.
Lichinar there going with a bad pass to Horvath when really what he should have done was just touched it nicely back to Best, who had cut into the receiving position, and Georgie Best quite upset with that, understandably. He's expected that kind of return given his plenty of years of experience at the international level.
Close marking by San Jose. Trying not to allow the Cosmos to build, and they've actually done a pretty good job with it, Seamus. When the Cosmos took their first real opportunity well, they knocked it in the net and they lead 1-0. Time remaining, 33:06 in the first half. Prestatelli. Played with the Diplomats last year. So he's not a bad goal scorer. And playing with people like Alan Green up front with Washington and Johan Cruyff, he was fairly effective. I don't know if he's going to have that kind of help around here.
Well, he came in the middle of the season in Washington when they had so many injuries there, and he scored 15 goals before the season was over and got a handful of them in some key games. So he really was quite a shock to the Washington fans and maybe to some of the other Washington players.
Hyde Horvath. San Jose also have Alan Merrick here, who played many years for Minnesota and then last year with L.A. Foul on Bandoff as he ran Georgie Best off the ball. Cosmos 81 home season at Giant Stadium in the Meadowlands, 2 short weeks away. The home opener against the Minnesota Kicks. I'm going to tell you a lot about that game. There's a great giveaway that we'll be talking more about at halftime. Tremendous book called Cosmos Headlines. of Cosmos history, and what a decade it's been. Again, we'll give you more about that as we go along. By the way, you can call and get your tickets. There's a yellow card to George Best.
Yeah.
Yellow card to Georgie Best.
He's been yakking at Cabrigian ever since that illegal tackle there. And by Bandoff, and Bandoff knocked him over, and he complained all along, and eventually went over the line. And another yellow card, Georgie Best. You'll see, here's the foul. Now, look at this. It's a very blatant foul. Not a very severe one, but a rather blatant one. He just simply pushes him over, and again, Best feeling perhaps that that was a yellow card offense.
Heidlichenauer has it taken away by Bogey from the blind side. 1-0 the Cosmos on top, 31-37 to play in the first half. Spartan Stadium, beautiful setting here. This is a beautiful stadium and a great setting, great part of the country with the mountains in the background. And again, these are great fans here in San Jose. They really supported this club from the very first in 1970. Now Romero on the left side. Knocked away. That's Alan Merrick, the veteran, good defensive midfielder. And they say it hit Romero last, so it'll be thrown in by Merrick.
That surprised Merrick, too. He's walking away with the ball in order to stall for time and finds out that he gets the throw-in. Jim, the other rule that we should mention very quickly is that they're now going to be using two substitutes rather than three. That is the international rule, and the North American Soccer League has agreed to use it now, at least temporarily.
All right, David's pass is broken up nicely by Wim Reisberg, and picked up by Edwin, given the right side. Now Gary outside the box. DiBernardo coming to mark him. The cross in front, picked off by Arushi, the sweeper. And a good release pass to Bogey to set it the other way. Now the Cosmos coming with a little bit of room. Now it's Bogey on the left side. San Jose was sending everyone forward that time. Cosmos with a chance and a good play by Hewitt as he came out to stop. Romero on the Cosmos should get corner kick from this.
Again, the overlap left side the far left side by the fullback Etherington coming up. That's what left the space there, and the ball played wide nicely out to Bogicevic, and almost got a goal from that in that quick counter.
Romero corner, not a very good corner. By the way, still time to get season tickets for the Cosmos 1981 season. You can do that right now. Number to call, area code 212-265-8600. 212-265-8600. And the Cosmos have staff members waiting for your call right now. All right, 1-0. In San Jose, the Cosmos on top, 29-44 to play in the first half. Kinalia from Vander Els. Did they give Bandoff an assist as well? Yes. Great pass by Boris to get it to Vander Els in space. Now Horvath in the air wins it. Now to Steve David. Steve David, this is the sixth NASL club sport. Good knockaway by Vander Els and a long, lazy ball toward Horvath. And Cabanas took it away. Bandoff under pressure just fired it toward midfield. Foul number six is going to be on Kinaya. This is Horvath. Now the Cosmos. Bogey, a beautiful ball. The Cabanas heads toward Giorgio in the middle. They head it back again toward Vander Els. Now Romero. Vander Els loves playing where he's at right now. Midfielder going forward. That was his position in Belgium. And in the 4-4-2, that's the way he's going to be playing for the Cosmos.
Well, one of the interesting things right away, of course, is that there's so much more central attacking by the Cosmos. They may be wide and early on, but the finishing thrusts are much more central than have been in the case in the past when they had three players up front and they play wing play. But so far, they haven't not needed to do that because they're getting some good opportunities through the middle, and they can exercise the one-touch passes because they have the skillful players who can do it coming through.
28-08 to play first half. 1-0 the Cosmos against San Jose. Romero, midfield, a lot of red shirts there. To DiBernardo. Quickly to Bogey on the left side. Headed away nicely by Horvath. DiBernardo, a drive, and he just missed it. Angelo, a left-footed drive.
Well, you love to see Angelo line these up because he's got such a powerful left foot, that great goal he scored in Atlanta last season. I'll never forget. Here you see him letting it go again. Hewitt really with no chance, even if he'd gotten to it, I think it would have been very hard to stop, but as it was, just whistled by the post.
Hewitt, one of the two, and on the field, at least playing, that were here in 76 when the Cosmos lost 2-1. The other was Giorgio Chinaglio.
Right.
Playing for the Cosmos. Actually, there was a third player on the field that night, but he's an assistant coach now, Ilja Mikic. So actually, the three top scorers, all-time scorers in the NASL, are on the field this afternoon. Chinaglio, number one, David, number three, and Mikic, not playing, retired, number two. All right, here's Merrick to Rutanski. Rutanski, now their sweeper. You notice they've got 10 men over the midfield line right now, San Jose. All right, Bogey to the midfield line. And now Reisbergen, DiBernardo. Angelo under pressure pushes Etherington from behind, and the official saw it all the way. Cabrician made the call. Angelo tackles, stolen. Bogey now to Romero. Van der Els, Romero, good ball, Reisbergen. Van der Els, oh, he just missed.
Oh, wonderful central attacking opportunities again. You see what I'm talking about. These great central chances are coming. They don't have to rely on the wide runs now because these players are coming into good positions and have got the nice ability to make the 3 and 4 and 5 yard quick touch passes. Great chances for DiBernardo a couple of minutes ago, and there Van der Els almost put one away.
Tough to play a team, too, that has four midfielders like that and play that way because it's just hard to defend against them.
There you saw that nice pass from Reisbergen, and Van der Els with the shot just by the post.
Hi, Crescitelli now in the right corner for San Jose. They're in the Cosmos third, or the offensive third. All right, San Jose looking to attack. David played to the fullback right side. Here's Geary with a lot of room there. Romero will come to try to knock him off. Around Romero. Etherington, a drive that's smothered by Birkenmeyer.
Good piece of work by Gary Etherington there, who got around Romero with remarkable ease. Romero coming back to do his midfield job. There you see he's cut inside. Now he's got his left foot. So he fires with a left foot, doesn't try to get it back on the right, and a good grounder that Hubert smothers nicely.
All right, we're back to the live action now. And a foul against Wim Reisbergen. All right, we told you that Jeff Durgan, Cosmos' outstanding stopper, not playing, he's a little under the weather. He's with us in the booth. Jeff, I know you feel you'd rather be on the field.
Well, I'll be back, you know, soon enough. I've got to take some time off now to get my physical condition back.
All right, now what about the game as you see it so far? Are you happy?
I'm happy. I think we could move the ball up a little bit faster. San Jose hasn't quite gotten anything together yet, so they haven't posed a threat. You know, I hope George has fed some more balls, give him an opportunity.
Well, you've heard Seamus and I talking about this 4-4-2. Well, what's your view of it? Do you like the Cosmos playing this system?
Yeah, my only experience with it so far is against El Salvador in L.A., and I really liked it. I liked the way the team worked with it.
Now, on the tour, on the 25,000-mile South American tour, they did not play with it much?
No. Hennis put that in first in L.A.
Jeff, good luck. We hope to see you back soon.
All right, I hope to be back next week. Thank you.
Okay, Jeff Durgan, outstanding young American defender for the Cosmos. Hi, here's Steve David. Here's a great chance for Bass. Didn't get a lot on it. I think he wanted to lift it over, but he just couldn't get it up. Get it done.
No, that's the best of today as opposed to the best of 9 years ago when that ball would have been dispatched without any hesitation in the corner. But he just simply doesn't have finishing power anymore. It's sad to see in a way, and I know, let's be fair to him. He's still not in any kind of shape to be playing and will probably just play out this half and be substituted. But it was a classic best opportunity that simply was not executed.
By 23:09 to play in the first half, and the Cosmos on top 1-0 on a Chinaglio goal, pass from Van der Els and banned off 3 minutes into the game. Reisberger now. Bim. Chinaglio. Shot by DiBernardo. Giorgio, just a little touch pass to Angelo, and he missed the post. Cosmos' first regular season home game is on Sunday, April the 12th at 2:30 p.m. against the Minnesota Kicks. All persons attending that day will receive Cosmos in Headlines. That's a 48-page book containing highlights of the Cosmos' first decade of existence, and that's courtesy of Budweiser, and that is a sensational giveaway. And that goes to every fan, by the way. Every fan that attends the game. Again, we'll have more on that at halftime. Long ball now Lichtenauer. DiBernardo got on him, and Lichtenauer lost the ball.
Riceburgen has become a real offensive weapon for the Cosmos today. You see how many times he's come up through the middle. He's able to leave his man Steve David because I think, frankly, Steve David does not have the jet-like speed that he had many, many years ago. So you don't have to worry too much about him getting behind the defense. And so he can afford to, that is, Riceburgen can afford to go forward a lot more. And he's done some very real damage up there. Just been a little bit off. And the Cosmos have been a little bit off in finishing, but he's been the one who's been pushing that dangerous ball into the penalty area.
Mike Georgie Best now will have the free kick. Talking about dangers, he can usually put it on a dime. And Bogey got in the way of David, a looping ball into the box. The speedy Steve David was about to get under it, and Bogey came over and knocked it over, gave away a corner kick.
Very cool play, though, by Bogey. Didn't panic. Never does, of course. It's the way for a corner. Good move.
Good corner. Bergenmeyer, a good punch out. Alan Merrick. A little bumping. Now they're going to call what? On Georgie Best.
Yeah, I think they're going to call it for holding. Georgie thinks it may be for him, no? Bandoff in that battle over there with Georgie Best. Comes out a winner this time. Morris, as you see, began his career here, went to Silver Creek High School and broke into San Jose. Was always considered a bit of a disappointment out here because the fans expected an awful lot from him at a very young age. And it was kind of a rough baptism for him. So he doesn't mind if he gets a boo out here or two as a member of the opposition because he's been used to it.
Mike Horvath with a foul now, fouling Manuel. Cosmos get it. By Rick Davis. Bobby Arushi back with the Cosmos. Davis. Headed away by Jimmy McAllister. There's the Arushi. Off the mark with a header. And out San Jose on the attack. Coming to the midfield line. Lichtenauer plays it to Horvath. Attacking from the left wing. The long cross to David just over his head. Not a bad idea. The curling ball just a little high for Steve David.
Has played beautifully into Steve David's path as he's running through. And again, I think he may have misjudged a little bit because I've seen him get balls like that before in the past and either take them down or it was a little high for that, but certainly put a firm header on goal. But he just didn't seem to rise well enough for it.
Right, Romero. Horvath gave a little bump to Vander Elst, and he never had a chance for the ball. Now here's Joe. Lichtenauer. He's their creative midfield. He and Horvath. Nice return by David, but picked off by Riceburgen, who saw the pass all the way. Now Cabanas to the midfield line. David stops him. Good pass to Bogey. DiBernardo's up the left side. Cabanas. Vander Elst, the shot. And Hewitt with it.
Good idea by Vander Elst. Some of the other players thought maybe he would have passed it off, but a lot of the other players looking for the pass were tightly marked, and Vander Elst thought he might be able to squeeze it through the crowd there, and he almost did.
Now Cosmos applying a little bit of pressure, not letting San Jose build, and they have to force it back. And now here's Powell, the stopper. Etherington, the right fullback. Good ball by Etherington. That's the sweeper back, Vasa Rutanski. Vander Elst, a steal, trying to lead Kinaya, not dangerous, and quick throw, a good throw on the right wing, goes to Etherington. Free again from Rutanski. Here comes Lichtenauer. A lot of white shirts, headed down and intercepted by Riceburgen. Now Vander Elst with room, over the midfield line. Cabanas on the right, Romero on his left. They go to Kinaya, a little back heel. Kind of back heel for Vander Elst coming through.
Alan Merritt, I think, suspected it was coming because he covered him beautifully in front ahead of the way. Now here comes Horvath with his favorite left side run.
This is dangerous. David. David. Just got too wide with it. Just kept cutting his own angle down. Of course, the defender did a pretty good job, too. There's Vander Elst. Touches it now to Cabanas on the right of the box. Romero, a drive over the top. What a tough shot. Running right and then firing back over the... And he got it up just high.
Well, but beautiful control in the initial reception of the pass as he was just about to be tackled. He touched the ball, jumped in the air, avoided the tackle. Now watch this lovely reception here. Cabanas gives him kind of a tough ball. He comes in, lovely skip away from the defender, almost catches the far corner. That's the wonderful, thing about Romero is that what looks like a 50-50 ball being played to him, he just has that extra bit of skill and speed that is going to exploit the opportunity 80-90% of the time.
And Merrick volleys it high. Arushi volleys it right back. Gary Otherington. Now Merrick for Rutanski. Chess and then has it stolen and gets it right back again. Not much of a shot. Now again, San Jose's caught upfield. Those are not playing it quickly, Seamus.
Didn't have enough players, I think, back up front. A lot came back. You saw Cabanas, in fact, came back on that occasion and then made the big wide run out here, but he was not seen early enough by Boogie. There is a bit of a wind swirling around down there, which is going to make the long ball a little bit tricky, too.
All right, 1-0 the Cosmos, coming up on 16 minutes to play in the first half. By the way, at halftime, we have our director, Elliot Terrell, has put together a nice piece on Giorgio. Talk about the opening game with Minnesota and some highlights of the great Minnesota Cosmos rivalry, which has been going on since 1975 when Minnesota came in to the league. And then we'll have some first half highlights, so stay tuned at halftime. 15:34 to play in the first half, and the Cosmos lead. 3 minutes into the game, they got a goal from Kinaya. It stood up so far. Horvath passed too long. Vander Elst knocked it away.
Cosmos still trying the middle, and Kinaya, as a result, not getting very many passes. That may seem a strange thing to say, but in fact, Kinaya is the one who's a decoy far too often so far.
Actually, San Jose's best chance came very early in the game when Cresatelli came in all alone on the right side, and Birkemeyer came out and made a sliding save. Bogey under pressure. Oh, brilliant pass. Weisbergen overran it. And now to Romero. Van der Elst trying to get it to Giorgio, but a good play by the sweeper, Rutanski. Tried to chip it over Rutanski's head. That would have brought Giorgio in on goal. Now a good pass to Horvath. San Jose coming. Lichtenauer
trying a very difficult thing there, Jim, running over towards his left and then spinning on his right foot and trying to hit a shot with his left foot. Very tough thing to pull off and rather easy for the goalkeeper to deal with.
I best knocked it down. Georgie was supposed to play about 30 minutes of this game. Well, played more than that right now.
Yeah, I think they revised that to a half. I think they thought they would try to put him out there for a half and see if he could pull out a goal for them, but so far he really hasn't looked too dangerous.
Well, they haven't really gotten well much.
No.
He had a chance also early, and I think he was trying to lift it over Birkenmeyer, but didn't hit it very well and rolled it to Hubert, but he has not been given the ball much.
Has got to be hit just right for the secondary players to react to the flight of the ball, and if it's a little bit off, then it's hard for them to figure out where it's going to be when it's flicked on.
All right. They tell him to play on, and it's saved by Birkenmeyer. Cresatelli knocked Ricky Davis down, and Cosmos were looking for a call. By Cosmos coming on the attack now. Van der Elst, and his trip. Francois Tripp. Van der Elst, and now a yellow card coming to Alan Merrick. Alan Merrick fouling Francois Van der Elst. I'm sorry we had some technical problems, but we're back. It's still a 1-0 game. The Cosmos on top, 9:56 to play in the first half. Yellow card, we've had two yellow cards, one to Georgie Best for dissent, and now to Merrick for that foul against Van der Elst. Headed away by Jimmy McAllister of San Jose, now to George Best. George Best, handoff coming back. Great pass by Best, got it to David. David marked by Weisbergen. Ben knocked it away, but they give a corner kick. Corner kick to San Jose.
Good defensive work, though. Two men on one, which is what you want in the penalty area. Hirushi coming over, being the first defender, faked to David, and David went the second way, and Rice here to play it away. Good defense.
High corner kick
Georgie Bass. A very good corner. Romero clearing it out. Merrick picks it off. Merrick's pass off the head of Lichtenauer, picked up by Joe Horvath. Watch that left foot. He can really bomb it. He bombed it off the ankle of Yarushi. Good job with clearing by Banoff. That ball almost went over the line for another corner. Now Georgie Bass. Horvath open on the left side. DiBernardo comes to play him. Cross is knocked out momentarily. Now Bogey. And Bogey got a very high foot up there, and I believe in McAllister. McAllister's jumping up very quickly, though.
He's also grinning from ear to ear. That's a good call by the referee, because although I don't
care whether he hit him or not, that's a call.
That's right. Here you see the high foot coming up, McAllister going with the head, and that clearly dangerous play by Bogey. And
I could have hurt him.
Yeah.
Good thing it didn't hit him. Now they'll do it again. 8:07 to play in the first half, and the Cosmos on top of 1-0. Jim Karvellas, Seamus Malin, Spartan Stadium, San Jose, California. All right, let's see who takes this. David. And Merrick. Way off the mark.
Well, it didn't look like a very well-rehearsed piece of work, did it? In fact, the ball went out over the sideline. It's a throw-in being taken down the corner here by Vanderals, who puts it into Hubert Birkenmeyer and then gets it back. But that did not look like a very polished piece of set play.
All right, Francois Vanderals. Around Horvath. Cabanas. Vanderals. Nice tackle by Merrick. Cabanas. And a foul on Jimmy McAllister.
Lovely piece of skillful work there by Cabanas. Had a little chance to get the ball. Pushed it well by McAllister. McAllister reached over and hauled him down, because otherwise Cabanas is going in free around the corner.
All right, here's a view of what Cabanas has in front of him. Now the referee blows the whistle. And he tells McAllister to get back.
McAllister complaining that Cabanas handled the ball initially. San Jose needs to stop worrying about calls and just get their game together.
All right, Romero. Oh, almost. Everyone converged on Quinalla, and Cabanas came free there with the ball slipped by. Winner kick.
Yeah, a defender touched it on. A good chance for Cabanas, but the ball is deflected too late for him to react to it.
All right, Seamus, let's see if what you've been saying is going to work here. They've been trying to go to near post. Now they have Cabanas at the near post.
Okay.
Yes, they do, but it goes low into Horvath. They'll do it again. Off Horvath. Now a short corner to Bogey. Horvath knocks it away again. Another corner kick. Time ticking away. 6:07 to play in the first half. Here's a good corner. And McAllister got ahead on it. We'll have a corner kick now from the right side. That was a dangerous corner swerving in.
Well, you got to mix them up. You keep playing them to the near post, they're going to become predictable, and defenders can simply go out and put pressure on the pass receiver and make it very difficult to do anything. So you've got to vary it. Let's see what Bogey will do this time. Maybe he'll go wider. Look for Iarushi, perhaps.
Nice play by Hewitt. They were going toward Iarushi. High Lichtenauer for San Jose. Good ball. Wide open Horvath. For David. Off his chest. David, very fast. In fact, he's been in this league 8 years. In Trinidad, as a teenager, he ran the 109.3. He did the hurdles in 13.8. Those are world-class times. And he had a great line. He said he didn't, everyone's so fast over there, he didn't think he was fast until he came over here.
Well, you've heard of the flying nun. I think he was called the flying cop down there, wasn't he? Wasn't he a policeman for a while?
They had a bunch of kids from Trinidad. Archibald came out then, Leroy DeLeon. Great soccer players. Skillful. In the box, fast-headed, Cresatelli off his head. Reisbergen. They didn't get a high foot call that time, although Vim might have hit the San Jose player. Vim is attending to him in the box right now. The play goes on.
Horvath.
Now, and Kabrichian stops play now. Tickets for all Cosmos home games available at the Cosmos Ticket Office, 75 Rockefeller Plaza, Giant Stadium, Gate B. At Ticketron, Charge It, Madison Square Garden, and branches of the Fidelity Union Trust and branches of the Manufacturers Hanover Trust Company. Call that number right now and get Cosmos season tickets.
There's some great clubs coming into the stadium this year, L.A. and wonderful new rivalries, too, and they're now going to be established because of this realignment. Let's take a look at this collision. Now, you'll see that Weisbergen's coming out for the ball, and I think that Horvat will turn away just at the last minute. Yeah, he turns a little bit and catches the leg or knee, perhaps, of Weisbergen as a follow-through, and I think that's what's upset him. He did not get the studs, I think, in the back or anything like that, but I think he got the knee in the stomach as he fell.
Cosmos wish to acknowledge the continued support of Joe Manfredi and Safe Toyota as the official automobile dealer of the Cosmos, of El Ace, the official outfitter and uniform supplier of the Cosmos, and the Bahamas Princess Hotels, official training site of the Cosmos. All right, 1-0 Cosmos, 4:19 to play here in the first half. All right, Bogey, not a Romero. Romero touches to Weisbergen. Stepped around the official to get to the ball. Yarushi. Bobby still with the ball. And now Bogey attacking from the left. Romero in the middle. Not a very good ball, trying to feed Giorgio.
Well, it's very ironic that with all this sort of centrally oriented attack, they still have not been able to get many chances to Canalia, but the other players have had a lot of opportunities.
All right, Horvath plays it deep for the overlapping fullback. Etherington was there and then looked up and forgot to look back at the ball and it skipped over his foot. He had a lot of room over that. Romero. Back to Romero from Bandoff. Best, Lichinar, Georgie Best. 3:14 to play in the half. Horvath, touch on to McAllister, and it's inbounds. But Cabanas a good job to hustle back. So good effort by McAllister coming up from his left fullback spot. Last touch by Bobby Arushi. It'll be a throw in San Jose under 3 minutes to play in the first half. Bandoff knocked it away from Best. Romero to Weisbergen. Him, DiBernardo. Lichinar on DiBernardo. Now Bogey. Romero. Nice ball, DiBernardo. Cross for Giorgio, foul knocked it off. Bogey, and a foul on Bogey. Bogey, who probably uses that body better than anyone, shielding the ball.
Yeah, he was trying to shield the ball. The ball was running a bit too freely away from him, so he was not really within playing distance when he was doing the blocking out, and Cabrigian, I think, properly whistled him up for that.
Right, here's Gary Etherington at the midfield line for San Jose. Now Rutonski, the sweeper. Lichinar. Bogey to pick him up. Horvath. Merrick. Long far post pass to Crescentelli. And picked off by Birkenmar. DiBernardo with a minute 19 to play and a half. 1-0 Cosmos. Weisbergen. Through to Cabanas. Cabanas gets free. Quinalla trying to get it back to Cabanas. Was tied up. Here comes Romero. Quinalla was really concerned because yeah. Cabanas was obstructed.
Not only that, Gary Etherington held the ball on his on the ground with his hand when in the penalty area and he fell over. But I think the referee must have thought he just sort of fell on the ball rather than stopping it. But it certainly had the effect of preventing Romero from getting in on a 1-0 against the keeper there. And Giorgio unhappy talking to Cabrigian because that was a great chance for Romero and the hand of the fullback Etherington stopped that play from really turning out to what would have been, I think, an easy second goal.
All right, foul against the Cosmos will be free kick. 23 seconds. DiBernardo. Let's see, are they going to give throw in a corner? We have 5 seconds. They're going to give throw. Clock reads no time remaining, and that's it. That is the end of the first half here at Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. And the Cosmos and San Jose walk off the field, and it's 1-0 Cosmos, an early goal by Giorgio Chinaglia, and the passes from Bandoff and Vanderels. At the end of the first half, the score, the Cosmos 1, San Jose nothing. Cosmos soccer.
This bud's for the guy.
Of Giorgio Chinaglia, all the emotions of a superstar playing the world's super sport, soccer. And when that face looks toward the goal, the ball usually follows into the net. League record is the market athlete, but to hold them all is greatness. Giorgio Chinaglia holds every possible league goal scoring record. Last year he led the world in goals. Giorgio had the best all-around season in NASL history, winning his third regular season league scoring title. Then on May 16th in Anaheim, California, a fantastic wheeling shot made him the NASL's all-time leading goal scorer. Giorgio was labeled Mr. Playoff when he scored a staggering total of 7 goals in a second leg playoff match against Tulsa, a modern day world record. Giorgio scored 18 times during the playoff series, extending his career playoff record to 38 goals and 86 points. No other player in league history has even 10 goals or 20 points. Of course, Giorgio was named first team All-NASL, which was for the 4th 5 years. Chinaglia's records are like a never-ending string of pearls. 1976 set NASL regular season single game record of 12 points, holds multiple goal scoring record, and in 1978 again changed league history with his record regular season scoring of 34 goals and 79 points. Makes Giorgio Chinaglia the world's super striker. A player, yes. But more, Giorgio is a soccer. And it's exciting to watch him score. He's excited too, for his team, for himself, but most of all, for his fans.
You know what we like best about our new Dot?
Hi, we're at halftime here in San Jose, California. Jim Karvellas, Seamus Malin, 1-0 the Cosmos. 3 minutes into the game, Chinaglia from Vanderels. But the Cosmos haven't broken away from San Jose, so it's still anyone's game.
That's right, and in fact, they've had many chances going through the center, which is encouraging to see and very nice for fans to watch, but the execution's been just a little off, but you get a feeling that the floodgates could open.
All right, now next Saturday night, Seamus and I will be in Jacksonville, Florida. And the next game after that, which will be our home opener, if you will, a homecoming, because the Cosmos fans haven't seen their club since September 24th, farewell game for Franz Beckenbauer. So they're going to be back
and they're going to be playing the Minnesota Kicks, a team that's always been a great rival. And Seamus, as a giveaway, the Cosmos have, I think, maybe the best giveaway I've ever seen. It's a book, here it is, called Cosmos Headlines, The First Decade. 48-page book featuring the Pelés and the Beckenbauers, the Quinalhas, and all the great players that have played with the Cosmos. And by the way, that doesn't go to the first 20 or 30,000 fans or 16 and under youngsters. That goes to every fan that attends the home opener on the 12th of next month, Giant Stadium at 2:30.
That's a great booklet indeed, because not only is it about the Cosmos, but it's really a history of modern world soccer, because so much of what the Cosmos have brought to America has been world soccer.
All right, the Cosmos and the Minnesota Kicks have played some classic soccer games. And I think when we talk about the great games, I think the one game that we all remember is 78 shootout at Giant Stadium. Let's go to it one more time.
Franz Beckenbauer. Now it's up to Franz, a man that knows pressure. He knows World Cup pressure, European Cup pressure. Now he can win it for the Cosmos. Beckenbauer. Lettieri out. Franz. Shot, goal! The Cosmos have won it. An incredible comeback. The Cosmos advance to Portland. The Cosmos still alive on a Beckenbauer goal in a tremendous shootout.
That's just some of the excitement. That's just some of the excitement that's been Cosmos Kicks excitement over the year. And the home opener at Giant Stadium in a couple of weeks, and it should be something. That's the 12th at Giant Stadium, Sunday afternoon, 2:30 start. And again, the headliner's book as well, Gate of Great Cosmos Soccer. That's 48-page book that's to everyone that comes into the stadium. Seamus, Minnesota has a different club this year. They've really gone for some soccer superstars.
That's right. They're continuing in kind of an ambitious program, it seems to me, to combine the best of South America with the best of England. And they're now bringing in Ruben Pagnanini, who is the first member of the Argentine 1978 team to sign a contract with a North American soccer club. And they're also just on the verge of getting Steve Highway, that great player from Liverpool and the Republic of Ireland. So those players come into Giant Stadium on the 12th of April. That's going to be a super team to watch.
All right. The NASL now, 21 teams for the 80-81 season. And let's take a look at the new alignment in the North American Soccer League. The new alignment. And Seamus, let's talk about this. First of all, the Northwest Division.
The Northwest Division, of course, has Vancouver, Edmonton, and Calgary, three teams from Canada, and that ever-dangerous Seattle team who are going to be as tough as ever, Portland. Further to their south in the west, we'll be here in San Jose, of course. L.A. and the California Surf and San Diego getting off to a good start yesterday. And now in the Midwest, the real black and blue division, I guess they call it, and well named, Minnesota, Chicago, and the ever-tough Tulsa Roughnecks and Dallas, who gave the Cosmos such a hard battle last season.
That's the Central Division. All right. And the Eastern Division, Montreal, Toronto, the Cosmos, and the Washington Diplomats, and the Southern Division, Atlanta, Jacksonville, Tampa Bay, and Fort Lauderdale. So that is a new alignment in the North American Soccer League. But any way you cut it, no matter who the teams are, you know that they all love to play the Cosmos. It's an amazing thing because people talk about rivalries, Seattle against Portland, Tampa Bay against Fort Lauderdale. All the teams have rivalries. The Cosmos have 20 super rivalries because every time they play the Cosmos, it's their biggest game of the year. Jacksonville next, since that's the T-Men franchise. I don't have to tell you about the great games the T-Men have played against the Cosmos and have been very successful against the Cosmos, and that'll be next Saturday night. So no matter whether they call themselves Jacksonville or New England, it's the T-Men against the Cosmos. And an old nemesis, Seamus, Alan Green from Washington, now playing with him. And Alan did quite well last night as Jacksonville got off on the right foot.
He sure did. That was a big surprise because they took on that tough Toronto club. They beat them 1-0 at home, and they got a great turnout of over 17,000 people down there in Jacksonville. And now they have the Cosmos coming in for their second game, so they're off to a great start. And let's hope that franchise does a lot better than they did in New England, which was really unfortunate.
That'll be next Saturday night. You can see the game right here on WOR-TV television. All right. As far as halftime stats are concerned, let's take a look at those. The Cosmos leading here 1-0, and the goal by Giorgio Quinalha. As far as saves are concerned,
well, you see the shots are pretty close. San Jose taking long-range shots. The Cosmos much more close in, 11-10. Saves 2-5. Hubert Birkenmeyer not really being troubled except by one or two, perhaps. Big edge and corner kicks for the corner for the Cosmos, 6-2. They had four together at one point. And, of course, that one goal by Giorgio Chinaglia right at the top of the game from the assist by Vander Ellis and Boris Bandov.
All right. And the big stat, of course, is the Cosmos on top 1-0, and it happened very early in the game. Very, very early in the game, Chinaglia scored one of his very few chances this afternoon. But luckily for the Cosmos, he converted on a great pass from Vander Ellis, who had a very good pass from Bandov. All right, Seamus and I are going to be back with more halftime. All right, we're at halftime at Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. Jim Karvellas, Seamus Malin, 1-0, the Cosmos on top, Chinaglia's goal. Yesterday's action, by the way, around the North American Soccer League as the season got started last night. As we told you, Jacksonville, a winner, 1-0 on an Allen Green. Tulsa, now this is really a surprise, at Tampa Bay. Tulsa beat Tampa Bay 2-0. Fort Lauderdale, well, let's go back to the Tulsa game. I think there was an interesting thing in there. Mr. Maroney got a goal. The number one draft pick got a goal with his first shot in the NASL. Youngster out of UConn. Other games, Washington was victimized by a late goal by Fort Lauderdale that tied it in regulation, and then Fort Lauderdale wins it in overtime over the Diplomats, 2-1. Then Seattle over LA at Seattle, 3-0. There was the biggest crowd in opening day crowd in Seattle's history, over 30,000. Portland, big win at California, 2-0. And San Diego, with a tremendous crowd of over 32,000, beat Vancouver 2-1 in the first shootout of the year. Francois Vander Ellis, who made that tremendous crossing Chinaglia to create the game's only goal, comes out as the Cosmos get ready for the second half. All right, the only goal, Seamus.
Okay, there's Vander Ellis going to the end line. You see the ball does not quite get away from him. It runs towards the line, but he's still able to catch up with it and bend it just at the last second. He clips it across. Chinaglia running in between two defenders, and the keeper cannot reach it, and Giorgio just hammers it in. A nice touch volley by Chinaglia. So dangerous when he's given that half chance.
Giorgio Chinaglia, the all-time leading scorer in the NASL, has given the Cosmos a 1-0 lead. The Cosmos 1981 home season at Giants Stadium in the Meadowlands is only 2 short weeks away. Still plenty of time for all of you fans to become a part of this exciting action out in Cosmos country by ordering season tickets. You can call the Cosmos office now and discuss season tickets for the upcoming year. Cosmos staff members are waiting for your call. You can now by dialing 212-265-8600. All right, we'll look for some changes, Seamus. Let's see if Georgie Best is out there. He is not. See who they brought in to replace him. The Cosmos wish to thank the continued support of Progresso Quality Foods. Details on how to become a Cosmos Progresso ball person are on the panels of selected Progresso quality products at your favorite food store. Well, Best is not on the field, and we'll pick up his replacement as soon as we can. All right, right now it's Cosmos, Bogey, Bandov. Cosmos started Bandov and Davis at the fullbacks. Yarushi as a sweeper. Reisbergen, stopper. Now it's Bandov attacking up the left side. Back to Bandov. Cosmos started four midfielders, Vander Ellis, Bogicevic, Romero. Knocked out of bounds.
The replacement
and
is
Bernardo.
The replacement is Mike Hunter. It was coming at defense, which means that Gary Etherington has moved up front, although I'm not sure he's moved up to form a three-man attacking unit. He may be a fourth midfielder. We'll watch that.
By watching now the corner kick. And the header by Chinaglia went wide. And it was knocked. Hit last by Powell. So the Cosmos get another corner kick. Romero in front. Julio Cedro. McAllister almost cleared it. And then goal kick.
Interestingly enough, Mike Hunter was the college roommate of Ricky Davis when they were both at Santa Clara together. And Ricky, of course, leaving after 1 year. I think Mike stayed on a bit and may be close to finishing his degree. And he's wearing number 3 and playing over there in the left fullback position. And Gary Etherington has moved up into the midfield. You see him under the ball here with DiBernardo battling for it. And he's playing on the right side of the midfield.
They were the principals in the trade, actually, when Etherington was traded to L.A. for DiBernardo and Larry Hulser. Actually, he wasn't the principal. It was Hulser that they were really looking for, I'm told, and it was Angelo that became such a big surprise. What a great year Angelo had. All right, ball knocked out of bounds. I believe it last touched McAllister. There's Bobby Arusi with the throw, deep in Cosmo's zone. Bogey, double team, stolen, but they fouled him. Kabrichin with a call. Just starting the second half, 1-0 the Cosmos.
And it's turned quite chilly all of a sudden. The sun has gone behind some clouds, and that wind has picked up a bit, just as it did here yesterday around 6 o'clock. It really got quite windy, and that could be a factor. But the Cosmos keep the ball on the ground, and as they had done in the first half, it shouldn't provide them with too much difficulty. But you figure that San Jose would hit a lot of long balls early on in the game to try to get somebody free. Might be victimized a bit by the wind. We'll watch it.
Hi, Rick Davis on the right sideline. Actually, the field is in very good shape.
Yep. Yeah, it's a nice field, actually.
Grass field. All right, San Jose moving. Came through to Arusi. Vesicelli now, Arusi picks him up. Davis in front. What a play by Reisbergen. Reisbergen came back in the nick of time to get a foot on that. Boy, that was a good ball, too, by Crescitelli.
Excellent ball, because Crescitelli had a legitimate chance himself. Look, you see, he's almost central to the penalty area. He could fire it, but he does a very unselfish thing. But Reisbergen, playing another outstanding game, comes back and cuts it away.
All right, Angelo DiBernardo. Cabanas, Reisbergen, Cabanas, Romero trying to touch it to Giorgio. Does. Cabanas from Romero, and almost.
A little bit overdone, I have to say. A few extra headers in there that weren't necessary. But again, the idea is nice, that sort of central attack and the interesting combination work. Very pretty to watch.
All right, from San Jose, California, it's the Cosmos 1. San Jose nothing. You're watching Cosmos Soccer.
This bud's for the guys who got what it takes to shake, rattle, and keep on rolling.
This bud's for you, for all you do. The king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you, that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This bud's for you.
Back before anyone ever dreamed of an energy crisis, a Sunday afternoon drive on quality General tires was...
Triple dip! Here I
well, pretty much for the fun of it. Today, we need more efficient driving, like making fun trips, work trips, on any of General's full line of radial tires that help save gas, Sunday or any other day. Quality, choice, price. General has a tire for you.
Sooner or later, you'll own General's.
All right, we played the 5 minutes of the second half. Still 1-0 the Cosmos. The best chance of the half belonged to San Jose on a Crescitelli pass for David, streaking in front, but Reisbergen got a foot on it. Handball. Handball against Bogey. Cosmos next telecast against the Jacksonville T-Men. That's next Saturday night, April the 4th, 7:30 p.m. right here over WOR-TV Channel 9. Not a good ball by Rutansky. Reisbergen. Cosmos, an extensive world tour. God, these kids have been on the road for a couple of months. And they did well on the tour, Seamus. Right here, DiBernardo. Now, Kinaya shot that just went wide on a pass from Romero. 6 wins, 5 losses, and a tie on the tour. Giorgio has scored the game's only goal.
Lovely pass from Romero there. Just here you see it coming up. Watch this. The little quick touch by him as the tackle comes in. A nice quick shot by Giorgio, but just past the post. Canalia really getting, I think, about his third shot of the game in. He scored on one of them, but that's about his average. I think he's sort of, I think he scores in one out of every three.
All right, Etherington on the right wing now. Davis got over there to make a good play on Lichinar.
Well, they keep trying to victimize Ricky Davis with these high balls, or perhaps counting him his lack of height to work to their advantage. But so far, it really hasn't hurt the Cosmos.
All right, now they're going to call a corner kick. Last touch for the Cosmos. And there is a lot of wind swirling up in the air, so these are really dangerous. Trying to serve it in front. Cosmos trying to come out on the counterattack. They've got some players moving. Van der Elst. Cabanas running in front of him through Roberto. Cabanas. Oh, he missed. He just flat missed it. He was looking. He was so intent on looking who was in front of the goal that he missed the ball.
Hard to know exactly what he was doing. I think, hopefully, he was trying to bend the ball across to Canalia on the far side, as he had taken a wide run and was open. But he just simply whiffed on it, as you say.
Good ball by David to open things up on the right side for Gary Etherington. As we go to the ground level and watch Gary working against DiBernardo, there's David. So there'll be a goal kick now coming up for Hubert Turk and Marangelo DiBernardo. All-American at Indiana University, drafted by Los Angeles, played his rookie year there, came with the Cosmos last year and had as good a year as you can have. Tremendous year, Angelo DiBernardo. Cabanas playing it back for Bogey. Romero, nice return to Bogey. Canalia just a little behind him. Romero comes in. Just a pinch behind Giorgio.
But Giorgio almost got it off. He made a nice turn and prodded it away, and instead of trying to take a shot, saw that Romero had read it and was coming in for the ball, and he played it nicely to him. There's a foul by Romero again on Horvath, kicking him from behind. I don't think intentionally Horvath ran across his path.
I don't think he kicked him. I think he pushed him. I think he was trying to stop him, and he just kind of gave him a shove.
Right.
It was kind of a late whistle, and Etherington with a quick move, but Bogey saw it. Well, Bogey really is going to be the maestro now. He's the old veteran in the middle of the field. And Kron's gone. A lot of responsibility for him. Oh, great chance. That was a great chance. Lichinar was right there, and he blew it. Hit it way over the top.
Well, a little bit of bad defensive play by Bogey, who gave the ball away on two occasions, and Horvath pulls it nicely back. He wants to get to his favorite left foot, and he skies a lovely ball across. Lichinar, well in position to get it, the easiest goal of the season for him, and amazingly heads it over the top.
And now Reisbergen is knocked down and fouled by Lichinar, and Kabrychin comes over to have a word with him. Wim Reisbergen. When you talk about a great professional, a true professional, you talk about this man. Wim Reisbergen, who's been outstanding in the tour. As Seamus said, he was outstanding in the soccer bowl. Actually, the last half of the season, he was just great. Cresitelli knocked away from behind by Bandoff. Nice play by Cresitelli. Came over and banged it off Angelo DiBernardo. 34-55 to play in the game. Mo's leading 1-0. They scored 3 minutes in. Jim McAllister, we remember him as an outstanding rookie for that Seattle club, Soccer Bowl 77. Cresitelli trying to play it to him. Actually, San Jose creating more opportunities now in the second half, Seamus.
They made good use of the ball in midfield there, making the Cosmos run around and not really get a tackle in, and a couple of undisciplined pieces of defense in the middle there by Romero and Cabanas, instead of holding their position, allowed themselves to be exposed, and it almost hurt.
And now a foul against Bandoff. Cosmos starting 5 North Americans today. In fact, the whole back line, with the exception of Reisbergen, North American.
Well, they're lucky to have been able to pick up Bobby Urushi, I think. He was always a good, hard-working player, and he's with the Cosmos before, and he did very well for Washington.
Very valuable player. He's very sound. He doesn't make many mistakes. You can play him at fullback. You can play him at sweeper. Good man to have.
Yes,
very. He has a great personality as well. Well liked by his team, and he's a winner. Won a lot of championship rings.
Captain of the Canadian World Cup team, in fact.
Right. Bogey intercept. Nice play by Bogey. Bim, the Romero, nicely back. Cosmos trying to string something together. Here's Bogey over the midfield line. Long lead, Romero. Oh. Boy, they were looking for Kinaya, I think, so Bogey put it on to Romero. It was a good ball. He just trolled it.
Lovely piece of diagonal work, though. The ball came from left, went diagonally to the right, and then ended up coming back to the left side, which is, of course, what you really want to do. You want to turn and lure a defense one way and then play it back into the area they've just vacated.
Giorgio made some space for Romero by making a diagonal run and allowing Romero to have the middle. Now Romero has the tackle away momentarily by David. Now one by Merrick. Now a battle. Cabanas took it away from Merrick. Now Reisberg into Romero. Open to Bogey on the left. They have two men on that side. Now DiBernardo with it. Bogey goes wide left and he gets it right back. Now in the middle and tackled by Witanski over the goal line. Corner kick Cosmos.
Cosmos looked good coming through the middle of the field when they released the ball quickly. The only time things look a little bit shaky is when they make that extra pass or two, that extra square ball or two in the middle, and then it sort of breaks down.
DiBernardo, that was a great corner pass. Now Vander Els, who hasn't had much of the ball in the second half, has way off his foot. Ricky Davis trying to steal it. Linesman said, no, that's not your ball.
That was a great shot again by DiBernardo. It caromed off a defender's head and came out, but that was marked goal all the way. I think people would not have gotten to that, and some defender really must have a heavy bruise there.
Mike Cosmos Avenue is Bogey. Not a Romero with Brutansky the sweeper on him. Romero now waiting. Pushes it to Vander Els. Vander Els has it tackled away momentarily by Horvath. Reisbergen. Giorgio to Bim. Good play. Good play by Hunter that time. Not a Horvath. Steve David at the midfield line. Good control it. Lost the ball. Fans booing a little bit. Now Reisbergen. Now David comes again. He can turn those boos to cheers, but now has to tackle away by Bobby Urushi. They boo again. It's a tough life for a goal scorer. It's a bad pass. That was Cabanas. Cosmos on top, 1-0.
That's a good ball by Cabanas. Makes up for it.
Vander Els crisscrossing with Romero. Now Romero gets it on the right. Now to DiBernardo, unmarked, cross. Headed away momentarily. Now Kinaya trying to play it back. And it goes right by Vander Els. And this is Horvath. Passing not very good. Either club at this point in the last couple of minutes. There's a man coming through. It's Vander Els. No, he's not offside. And what a save. And a shot and a goal.
Cabanas with a goal. Lots of claims for offside there. Cabanas slipping in behind it, saw the free ball coming up there, but
no,
Vander Els was
not offside. And we looked over at the linesman. As soon as Vander Els broke free, and the linesman was saying, play on.
Here's Vander Els. A good save here by Hewitt, who sprawls and knocks the ball away. You'll see Cabanas now coming in from the right side of your picture and pushes it very casually. Does a nice job, gets his foot right behind it, doesn't get it over the top, but leans and smacks it without any hesitation into the open net. Another good goal for Roberto Cabanas, who had a couple of great games on the tour, by the way.
So Cabanas has made it 2-0 to Cosmos. 15 and a half minutes or so into the second half. Mark Brickley gives us a time at 60:05 of the game. Roberto Cabanas to Cosmos on top, 2-0. All right, Vander Els to Reisbergen. The goal scorer, Cabanas. Lost it to Horvath. Irv has a good ball that Ricky Davis handles. Now, I tell you, Ricky Davis is going to get a yellow card for that.
That's right.
Yes.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. And that's a serious thing to do. I mean, obviously, San Jose had a good chance breaking down the left, and he reached up a hand and knocked it away, and that's considered to be unsportsmanlike conduct, which it is. And a little bit unlike Ricky, doesn't do that sort of thing, but it looked like the winger was off and running otherwise.
All right, San Jose now. Davis at fullback. Playing against his ex-roommate, as Seamus said, and getting a corner kick out of it. That was Hunter moving up on Ricky. That'll be corner kick San Jose. Horvath will take it.
Unorthodox attempt there by Ricky as he threw his body in front of the cross, almost like a hockey player going down in front of a slap shot.
Right short corner now to Hunter. There's driving cross, knocked out by Angelo DiBernardo. There's David being harassed and dangerous play. High kick against the Cosmos. Going to set up a free kick for the Earthquakes. Free kick for San Jose. It's the only game being played in the NASL today. San Diego, Portland, Seattle, Fort Lauderdale, Tulsa, and Jacksonville, all winners last night. In an overtime game, Lauderdale beat Washington, a shootout, San Diego over Vancouver. All right, the Cosmos running quickly now. It's Quinalla. Cabanas is up the middle there. Romero on the other side with Bogey. They go to the other side. Great pass. Romero, save. Bogey, side of the net. That was a great pass. Giorgio was aware all the time that Bogey and Romero were up the right side. The Cockenberg, Cosmos 2, San Jose nothing. You're watching Cosmos Soccer.
This Bud's for everybody who puts in a hard day's work.
This Bud's for you, for all you do.
Yeah, just for you, that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This Bud's for you.
All right, 2-0 the Cosmos on top. We have 26-27 to play in the game, and a foul call against Wim Reisbergen. Well, so the Cosmos was a golden opportunity there, Seamus, right, to make it 3-0.
Well, they really have the measure of San Jose, obviously, I think, and they just got to be careful they don't concede a goal, but this is a game you want to get 9 points out of.
Right offside, goal against San Jose.
Speaking of points, the one change in the point system this year in the league is that if you win a game by the shootout route, that you do not get the normal 6 points for a victory, you just get four, and this is to discourage teams playing defensive soccer and hoping to win in a shootout.
Good ball. Manoff got it to Bogey. Cabanas working up the right wing. They go to Cabanas. His cross is knocked down by Hunter. Cabanas back to Bogey on top. Bogey to Romero. Back to Cabanas on the right. Cross in front of the goal. Quinalla, great save. What a great save. Hewitt's made some great saves today. On that almost goal before the commercial by Romero, you have to give Hewitt a lot of credit for a great save there as well. And now he does it to Quinalla.
He's having a great game, no question about it. Nice ball played all the way across Giorgio in good position to push it in. A sprawling save, leg save there by Hewitt. But nonetheless, he got his body down and covered every piece of the area that he could.
Hewitt's an outstanding goalkeeper. Big favorite here in San Jose. Ive Reisbergen plays it toward the box. Horvath, a good pass. Steve Davis, the speedster on the left wing. Cosmos are back on defense. Romero stolen. The fans are getting a bit testy here. Here's Romero. Vanderels on the right. Pass for Francois and a good play by Hewitt. Cosmos starting to string things together, Seamus.
Well, that midfield group moves forward, not as four, but certainly as three of the four. It's just a white wave going up the field. It looks very impressive, and the intricate passing possibilities and the skill involved in these short passes among these talented players is really very interesting to watch, and quite a nice change of pace used to before of wide play.
All right, now it's San Jose's turn to attack. McAllister, bad pass. Weisbergen heading it down for Bobby Arushi. Now to Romero.
There we go, right
room,
down the middle.
Room for Romero. Ginaglia making a diagonal run. They go the other way to DiBernardo. And the referee says play on. And it's corner kick. He says corner kick.
The Cosmos' first regular season home game is on Sunday, as we said, April 12th, 2:30 p.m. against the Minnesota Kicks. Now, all persons attending that day will receive this great Cosmos in headlines, a 48-page book containing highlights of the Cosmos' first decade of existence, courtesy of Budweiser, and that is some souvenir you want to have.
High on the corner kick. Ball coming out. Bandoff heads it back. DiBernardo trying to control. He's banged by Rutanski from behind. Rutanski shot. Angelo a bit shaken up. Cosmos have somebody warming up in the sideline. We may have a substitute right now. Cenino coming in for Cabanas. All right, there's Angelo, and here's Cenino, who also had a very fine tour. In fact, it was up in the air which one of these guys would start today. Cabanas did start, scored a goal, and now Cenino comes in for him.
Well, one of the great victories on the tour was a 5-2 victory against the Paraguayan national team, in which Cenino got the Cosmos off to a great start by scoring two goals on assists from Giorgio. And you're quite right. He'll bring a little bit, if it's possible, a little bit more speed.
All right, on the free kick now, DiBernardo trying to chip it in, and no problem for San Jose that time. Lichinar. Weisbergen can't strip David of the ball. Play it back to Merrick. Jimmy McAllister. Intercepted by Davis. Romero. Angelo DiBernardo. Cenino operating on the right wing. That's not a good pass. Tony Powell moving on the attack. Arushi took it away. That's Cenino working with Horvath. Cenino. Now to Romero. Played on the left side. Now they change it over to Bogey. Angelo crosses behind. They go to Romero. Knocked away from him. David. Horvath. Vanderels did well to get back and stop Horvath before he became dangerous. Now Lutanski. The ball went straight up in the air. The pass. Good play, Arushi. Denied Gary Etherington. Bobby Arushi stopped Etherington. Romero's had some problems today trying to stop the ball and maybe beat people instead of getting rid of it.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. And a couple of occasions when they needed a quick release pass to get the play going in midfield, he's held it a bit. On the other hand, on attack in the penalty area, he's had some beautiful quick releases under a lot of pressure. But you don't want to see him holding the ball in the middle of the field. He's been doing that a bit too much recently.
Here comes Julio. And a call foul on Gary Etherington.
Let that one go, play the advantage rule there, because Romero was going in and looking very dangerous.
All right, Cenino with Hunter. Well, what a nightmare for a fullback, Cenino. And Bogey missed the half volley. Weisweiler about Romero says, we're quoting Hennis, he's one of the best players in the world and gets better all the time. I expect much bigger things from Francois Vanderels as well this year. He is healthy and rested, and attacking from midfield will be more suited to his style.
Oh, that's very true. I think we saw that especially near the end of the season. And the man you just saw on your screen a minute ago, Bogey, a heavy weight falls on his shoulders this season. And he's had, I think, what you would call a quiet game today. He's had some good moments early in the first half, but he's sort of been playing a more withdrawn position and allowing Romero to play a bit more forward, and Vanderels too.
All right, Witanski lost the ball. There's Cenino. See if he hears it out. He goes. There's Cenino. Great pass. Giorgio trying to wind and fire, but couldn't pull it off.
Good ball, too, from Cedinho. He made nice ground and beat the winger cleverly, cut to the byline and put it right on Giorgio's foot. It did the only thing he could, which is try to pull it and pivot on that right foot and smack it with his left. That's, of course, a patented move of Canali, as we saw the goal. That broke the record that way.
All right, Bergenmeyer came out quickly to pick it off before Steve David could get a foot on it. We have 19-15 to play in the game. The Cosmos leading 2-0.
Bergenmeyer not really having very much to do today. You see, he just simply has to come out and gauge his run, not under great pressure. David not going to challenge that hard for it. Hubert had a couple of key saves early on, but it's been a very quiet day for him, too.
All right, Cedinho. Seems to me, Seamus, that San Jose's biggest problem is their connection. They defensively, for the most part, is the connection between midfield and forwards. They just can't get the forwards the ball.
That's right. They are trying to break it as fast as they can. They know that if they lure the Cosmos players forward and pull as many players forward as they can, that there's going to be some spaces to go into. But their passing has been pretty inaccurate out of defense.
There's a good example of it right there. Not very good servicing passes. Angelo Di Bernardo over the midfield line now to Romero. Gets rid of it quickly to Reisbergen. One touch to Bogey. Van der Els. Now San Jose coming the other way. They have an advantage now. Good play by Bandoff to get a foot on that. Cosmos were caught that time with men upfield. They only had three men back, and in actual fact, they had five San Jose players getting attacked.
Well, when you bring players forward, one of the things you've got to avoid is trying to do one-on-one situations, and Van der Els made that mistake. He took a one-on-one situation instead of getting a little pass and getting it back, and he was dispossessed.
All right, Ricky Davis headed the corner that was coming to the near post to Horvath. Yeah, and they'll do it again. Lichtenauer taking the corner kick.
Very dangerous, too, because Horvath decided to let that go. He wasn't going to flick it on. He ducked at the last minute. That might have curved in.
High corner kick, San Jose. Oh, nice header by
Iarushi.
Bobby Iarushi right in front. Two pretty good corner kicks. High throw in Cosmos, Ricky Davis. Time remaining, 17 minutes in the game. 2-0 the Cosmos. First half goal by Quinalla, 3 minutes in. 15 minutes or so into the second half, goal by Roberto Cabanas. Band off. Romero, good pass. That opens it up. Van der Els. Di Bernardo, offside. Cedinho offside, trying to time his run, and just got offside.
Well, that's a tough run, and a tough pass to ask for, too, because Di Bernardo has to get that ball up in the air and over the defender. He couldn't really get it through on the ground, and of course, that ball will go slower when you do that to chip it.
All right, here's Horvath. Now to Steve David. Shot knocked down by Bobby Iarushi. Bobby's played a solid game as sweeper. Bogey. Time remaining, 15:55. 2-0 the Cosmos. Their home opener, same for San Jose. Here's McAllister on the right. Jimmy, played by Iarushi. Bobby knocked it down. It'll be throw in San Jose.
Now, there's no way McAllister's going to get around Bobby Iarushi.
Now McAllister again. Iarushi. Now it's going to be corner kick. Bobby Iarushi. That's right, he played for Toronto in 76 and the Cosmos 77 and 78. Not many people have three championship rings. Boy, that's dangerous. And David couldn't trap the ball very well. And stolen by Van der Els. Now to Romero. Julio Romero, Cedinho, back to Romero, Giorgio, headed away by Etherington. Now Bogey on the left, around McAllister, and stolen by Etherington. Cosmo's throw.
Good move by Bogey. He got McAllister up in the air with the fake, and Etherington came over as the covering defender, which is what you want. If a player goes in to commit himself, you want a second defender to come over there and do the job, and he did the job on Bogey as a second defender, but Bogey almost got away from both of them.
Battle, ball stayed in bounds. Now to DiBernardo. Angelo. Good skill. Tackle away and out clear. Now David's got a chance. The Riceburg is there. He got around Ben. Handball. Handball against David anyway.
Yeah, they all caught it. But again, the pressure came from unnecessary one-on-one situation in the middle of the field, and here you see what's happened. You see the ball coming through. Now, watch him touch
there
it with his hand.
Yeah. There it is.
Nice dribble.
And Bim with a quick call.
And the linesman right on the spot. The flag went up immediately.
Well, the sun came out in all its glory right now. You can see the shadow and the sun in the field, and that could give the goalkeeper a lot of trouble, and it's going to be Birkenmeyer in the sun. Now it's tucked back in behind a cloud. Handoff, rolling it back to Hubert Birkenmeyer. Hubert hasn't had a lot of pressure, but he did make two outstanding saves. One early in the game. On Cresatelli.
Cosmos need some ball possession here, and they're very capable of doing it, but they're just simply not pulling it off in the way that you know they can.
What a good ball. Riceburg can get it to Van der Els. In front to Giorgio. He dummied it by, but there was no one behind him. Giorgio hoping that Sininho was coming behind him.
Well, I think he may have wanted just to touch it off to Sininho, too. Sininho was coming in. I think he wanted to just give that little touch, and the ball just skipped by his boot.
All right, Davis. He gave a corner away. Davis and Gary Etherington battling, former teammates. 12-27, former roommates as well. I think he's rooming a lot of guys on this field. All right, corner kick now, San Jose. 2-0 to Cosmos. 12-19 to play in the game. Too hot. Cresatelli trying to center it back. And Arushi just bangs it out. Kyle heads it down. Etherington touches over to McAllister. San Jose and Birkenmeyer made the play. Nice play by Hubert. Came right out and took it away from Cresatelli. San Jose came out and created some opportunities in the second half. Arushi gave it away. And then San Jose created opportunities at the start of the second half, but not much recently.
Well, here's a long ball. Of course, this is a pretty easy ball for a keeper to come out under because it takes so long to get there, and he's a big advantage. And Hubert comes out, reaches well for it, and catches it at its top point and pulls it away very easily. But the Cosmos really are disappointing at this point because they're really not establishing the kind of possession game that we know they're capable of doing, and just simply frustrating the opposition. They're giving away much too much of the ball so far.
All right, 11-17 to play.
Well,
Horvath.
We couldn't do that before the game, I guess.
Yeah.
Got into the crowd during the game.
What Seamus is alluding to is the fact that players come out and then they kick the ball in the stands as they're introduced here in San Jose, and Horvath came out and missed the stands. Shanked the kick. But on this free kick, he knocks it seven rows back. Cosmos 1981 home season at Giant Stadium in the Meadowlands is only two short. There's still plenty of time for all you fans to become a part of the exciting action in Cosmos country by ordering season tickets. You can call the Cosmos office now, discuss season tickets for the upcoming season. Cosmos staff members are waiting right now for your call. You can reach them by dialing 212-265-8600. Jim Karvellas, Seamus Malin. 10.5 minutes to play in the game. The Cosmos lead San Jose 2-0. Cosmos have never won here. Two previous games, they lost in 74, and they lost in 1976, 2-1. Hewitt was in the goal that day for San Jose. Kinalyov was playing for the Cosmos, the only two players that are dressed today playing that were on their squads then. All right, Horvath, Bogey, got a head on it. To Sininho. To the mid, and now back to Bogey. Keeps it alive on the sideline. Cross field to change it. Let's see if it can be run down. Yes, Angelo can get it. David comes over. to Vim. Reisbergen under pressure from Lichtenauer to play it back. Now Romero. Nice touch over here to Vim. Reisbergen to Romero. Romero to Bogey. Cosmos keeping it away now.
Yeah, this is a little bit more of what I was talking about earlier.
Romero had it deflected. He was trying to touch it to Giorgio. Now Ricky Davis ranges back into his own zone.
Good ball by Ricky. Nice little chip pass.
Romero's pass is picked off. Horvath's pass is intercepted by Bandoff. To Reisbergen. Romero. Remaining 8:53 in regulation. Cosmos on top, 2-0. Rutansky the sweeper. The sun is back out, as you can see. And that's important, Ed. That sun is right in Berkdemeyer's eyes. And that's exactly the kind of a ball that can hurt him. Fans, we're getting ready to call for a penalty. Romero actually touched the ball.
Yeah, also unnecessary one-on-one. Here's a quick free kick.
Well, the sun won't give him any problem with that kind of ball. 8:15 to play in the game. Cosmos trying to win their home opener. Or their opener. Their home opener will be on the 12th of April in Giant Stadium against Minnesota. Going to win their opening game of the 81 season. They've actually done pretty well with openers in front.
Just not clicking up there in front. The game, I think, both teams sense is pretty well decided. San Jose really not willing to run that much anymore, and the Cosmos simply trying to now establish a bit more possession than they had been 10 or 15 minutes ago and use their superior skills to advantage. But they've just not been able to touch in the third goal.
All right, 7:33 to play in the game. Jim Karvellas, Seamus Malin, Spartan Stadium in San Jose. Bogey trying to keep it away from Gary Etherington, got his foot up too high.
Well, let's see if Gary ducked his head down a little bit here. I thought he went a bit low himself.
Ooh.
Well,
ooh.
No, I guess that is that's Bogey's fault, yeah.
Cosmos have never lost a home opener at Giant Stadium.
This is indirect free kick now, as a dangerous play.
Angelo heads it back to Berkenmeyer. Cosmos next telecast against Jacksonville's team end next Saturday. It's April the 4th, 7:30. Seamus and I will be there on WOR-TV, Channel 9. 6:39 to play in this game. Cosmos leading 2-0. 20,671. The record here is over 25,000. That was set the last time the Cosmos were here in 1976. Reisbergen and Ricky Davis. Ricky plays it wide. Sininho, the cross headed away by Rutansky.
A lot of the play for the Cosmos now eventually ending up out wide, but the central defenders are funneling back in and cutting down the passing angles because the ball is a little bit slower in coming through for the central attackers, unlike the early part of the game when much down the middle. So that's why I think you see Sininho's crosses being cut away fairly easily or just simply off their mark. It's a bit more difficult for him to thread the needle when the ball takes a little bit more time to get to him.
Long ball now, DiBernardo heads it away. Bobby Arushi has the ball. 5:25 to play in regulation. The Cosmos leading 2-0. Now Bandoff coming forward. Ridden off the ball by Cresatelli.
Boris upset there that he didn't get some help. Somebody telling that Cresatelli was coming from behind. He didn't realize he was there.
All right, Sininho against Hunter on the right side. Races by him. Look at that speed. In the box. And a save.
Good penetration by Sininho. Absolutely leaving Hunter in the... They're going right to the post, and then finding it a bit difficult to squeeze the ball across as Hewitt cut the angle down rather well, but Canale was waiting there in front.
All right, time remaining 4:43. Cosmos 2-0 leaders. You know they're going to really love being back home. Castelli breaks free on the right side. Iarushi knocked it away. They've been away for months on tours, and tonight they're coming home on a red eye. There's no complaints about flying all night long because they know they're going to be home, even though it's going to be 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. And Seamus, you know, one wonders also in looking at today's performance, it's been a workmanlike 2-0 Cosmos win. Nothing wrong with winning. We would have liked to see more goals, but one wonders with all the games they've played on this tour and everything, whether this isn't a good result under all the circumstances. With a lot of tough teams and been away from home a long time. You know they're going to love being back home.
He's got bogey way over wide here. He can get it to him.
Giorgio knocked away. Foul made the play. Now it's Horvat. Now with 3:40 to play in the game. Broken up by Vander Elst. Francois has done a lot of work defensively as well, Seamus. Impressed with that. Romero. Bogey. Now the Sun bothering both goalkeepers. Bogey. DiBernardo. Angelo's cross. Quinalla was right there but couldn't put a foot on it. David gave it up to Rutanski. Coming up on 3 minutes to play in the game. Cosmos leading 2-0. Rutanski trying to come through. Iarushi marks him. The sweepers on each other now. Cross to Horvath. He's got a lethal left foot. And there's Reisberg in with a sliding tackle. Vim made the play. Vander Elst to Quinalla. Coming in on goal, and it's a goal!
Well, Giorgio, a little frustrated this half. He's had a couple of good balls played into him. Others played a little bit off him, and there he finally gets free from his man who had gone up, and the great, nice little ball into him. He stayed onside, took it under control. Look at this, he's all alone. He's lost Powell. Keeper comes out, and it's just like a shootout for Giorgio, who hates the shootout, but that's what he does. He converts it nicely for that important ninth point, and this nine-pointer for the Cosmos. Here
give
we go.
Vander Elst
another
a lot of credit. That was the pass that set him free.
Second assist for Vander Elst. He's given two goals to Giorgio today. And a fine finishing effort by Quinalla to score one with just 2 minutes and 26 seconds to go.
All right. Horvath right now is in the penalty area.
Right. He went down in that tackle with Reisberg. And if you remember, he pulled the ball back onto his right foot to try to shoot it in. And Reisberg made a nice sliding tackle. Quinalla with two goals today. And I suppose that's hardly news anymore, but we got to keep remarking about what an outstanding performer this man is and how he's continuing on his goal-scoring rampart. He has a rampage. He had terrific...
Hi, there's Vim Reisbergen helping take Horvath off the field. A very legal hard tackle by Vim. Vim went in, tackled the ball away. There was no foul in the play, and Horvath went down. It's the third time that Joe's been down. So... Quinalla scores 3 minutes into the game and about 3 minutes before the end of the game. And in between a Cabanas goal has given the Cosmos maximum points. And Etherington bangs it over the top. And now the only thing in question is can Hubert Birkenmeyer get a shutout? There.
Well, we've jinxed Hubert with that question before. So maybe we shouldn't do that. Remember,
oh, that's right. We did do that last year, didn't we?
Yeah. Giorgio now has scored 18 goals in the last 13 games, including the tour in South and Central America and the two games in the LA Classic. And 18 goals in 13 games, much more than one a game, one and a half a game virtually.
Nice ball back to Vander Elst. Sininho on the right. It's a long ball, far post. Bogey. Bogey was trying to hit a flying wedge. Now it's Romero. A minute 30 to play in the game. 3-0 the Cosmos. That was there, but so was Bandoff, and Boris knocked it over the goal line. It'll be another corner kick for San Jose.
Nice ball from Alan Merrick. Alan, of course, been around, played midfield for many, many years, and a real honest player, as they say in the trade, works very hard. And he saw Cresitelli. Although Cresitelli was marked, he gave him the only ball you can give a marked player, which is one that keeps the ball away from the defender and gives the potential receiver a chance to do something with it.
Oh, there was a sun ball.
That was
went over the goal.
That was from Billy Sauter, number 19, who's playing over here on the right side. Now, who's come in for Horvath? He's gone out with that injury and still being treated over there behind the Hubert Birkenmeyer's goal. I think Horvath must have a suspect ankle, frankly, Jim, because this is the second or third time he's taken a blow on it. Although that was a pretty tough tackle, fair tackle, but nonetheless, he went down very early in the game with less severe a tackle, and then a second time in the early in the second half. So it's obviously something that's bothering him.
I want to welcome back Tom Werblin to our Cosmos broadcast team, our boss. Great to have Tommy back, and of course Elliot back, our director, and Seamus. And want to also wish Rich Dorfman a lot of good luck. Rich, you did the job last year with the NBA now. So it's nice to have Tommy Werblin back. And we start on a winning note for Tom. 3-0, Cosmos, 4 seconds, 3. Sauter with the ball. That's it. That is it. And the Cosmos have started the season on a good note. Coming into San Jose and winning 3-0, maximum points, 9 points for the Cosmos. As you see, Romero and Merrick exchanging congratulations.
The
workmanlike Cosmos right. Win, I thought, Seamus. Nothing spectacular, come out here and win. They didn't start all their players. Durgan was hurt. They've had some people out for
Eske.
One reason or another. Eske yep. out as well. But they got it done. They won 3-0 away from home. First time they've ever won in San Jose. And Giorgio Canaglia, the man there as always, didn't touch the ball much today, but he made the most of his chances. He scored twice. And both times, excellent passes from Francois Van Der Els. Cabana scored as well. We'll be back with a wrap-up. You're watching Cosmos Soccer.
For the guys who make our engines purr like a kitten and roar like a lion.
A great scene, a great setting for anything, and especially a soccer game. This afternoon, the Cosmos a winner, 3-0. They open their season on a high note. They win for the first time in San Jose, Seamus. And 9 points, good way to start.
Very good way to start, and they showed us in the first half some interesting new approaches to this game, a different kind of concept from what we're used to. Fell a little bit off in the second half, but it looked very, very good early on.
And they won 3-0, 2 goals by Giorgio Chinaglia. Well, next week, next Saturday night, we're gonna be off in to Jacksonville, Florida to play there at 7:30. We'll be with you then. Cosmos Soccer has been brought to you in part by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by Getty, who wants to get the most out of your car. And by the General Tire and Rubber Company, sooner or later, you'll own Generals.
Promotional consideration provided Vanshi Gentleman Underwear Collection, designed for sophisticated men of traveled good taste. Givenchy Gentleman, always the distinguished byword for men of fashion, available at fine stores throughout the metropolitan New York area. And by the members-only collection of fashion sportswear from Europecraft, the original strap-collar racing jacket. It's today's most exciting, most wanted jacket. Members only. When you put it on, something happens.